Hello everyone, in this let's study about the captive breeding. Captive breeding is basically where the wild animals are captured and then they will be raised and they will be allowed to breed. So all these activities will be done under the care of experts or wildlife biologists. So they will be monitoring if they are being raised properly or not. So what is the advantage of capturing and raising the wild animals? This basically gives the last chance to preserve the species. For example, here we can capture the wild animals, we can raise them, we can allow them to be, you know, kind of produce offsprings, and this will indirectly help in increasing the population of these wild animals. And once the population is increased and once you feel that they can survive, what we do is we just leave them in their natural habitats. That is, we go to the wild forest and we drop them there. So the other advantage is that the offsprings produced can be released into the wild, as I've already said, wherever the habitat is suitable for them to survive. It's not that you just go and release it wherever you want as per your whims and fancies. That habitat where you have released it should be suitable for its survival. And wherever its population is less or wherever its population has disappeared, probably that is the place where you can leave these offsprings such that it can again kind of grow big and produce offspring, and that help in increasing the population of these animals. And it also gives opportunities for genetic mixing, as I've already said. And it helps in improving the knowledge about the species, because once you bring the species and you help it grow, then you will get a better insight about the behavior of the species. You'll get to know a lot about the species, and this knowledge acquired during the captive breeding can be used for research purpose and all. And when research is done in an effective manner, that clearly indicates that we can effectively save these species in the near future from being endangered or from getting into extinct zone. And it also helps in expanding the range of the birds. When birds are captured and allowed to be breeded and then left in the wild, then all these collectively help in expanding the range of the birds. So and then let's understand the other question, that is when to start the captive breeding. We go for captive breeding whenever we find that a particular species population is dropping dangerously. And when the existing habitat is fragmented, then we can go for captive breeding, because it provides a hope for the species survival and it provides opportunities for genetic mixing as well. Or when the existing habitat of the species is degraded, that is of poor quality, then captive breeding can be done until its habitat is restored. That is, work on restoring the natural habitat of the species and then drop the species that is being subjected to the captive breeding. Or what we do is we provide an alternative habitat for these species such that they can survive. So these are the conditions as to when we can go for captive breeding. So it's basically whenever the population of the species drop dangerously, or whenever the habitat of the species is fragmented or degraded. These are the broader subheadings for this. So what we do is we go for captive breeding, and once breeding is done, we release these species into the wild forest. So some of the examples of captive breeding includes that of the lion-tailed macaque. I am not sure about this pronunciation, just check. And then we have these animals, which are present in Chennai's Eringar Anna Zoological Park, and they are also present in the Mysore Zoo. So that is it with this lecture. I hope you have enjoyed it. For more updates, you can also subscribe to this channel. Thank you.